calculator. Let's start out with the basics. So your on and off button, you understand, it's simple. But the part is that even if you switch off your calculator and switch on your calculator a week later or 2 weeks later, the data that was stored wherever in whatever positions on the calculator will remain to be over there. So until and unless you clear a data from a particular area, even switching off a calculator and switching on the calculator will not help you. Everybody with me? And the CEC button is just to clear. So in case I'm writing a 50 plus 6 on the screen, suppose I press CEC, that is your clear work. That's as it is in your normal calculator. Switch off and switch on is simple, you understand. This one is going to be a backspace. So say for example, I'm typing 98.25. I need a backspace. Again, a backspace for decimal, 980.25. So your backspace works on the decimal point as well and on the numbers as well. So this is your backspace key. Everybody can notice this is your backspace key. Everybody is comfortable understanding these are simple keys. Now, in order to scroll up and down, you have the arrow keys to scroll up and down. So these keys would be required. I'll show you in multiple functions. We'll be using the scrolling up and scrolling down key over here. Along with that, you have the second key, which kind of works, like a shift key. The shift key which you used to use in your scientific calculator. If I want to press an equal to, it's an equal to. If I want to press an answer, which is written, which is marked above the equal to button, I have to press second equal to. If I want to use the factorial sign above the multiplication sign, if you notice, I press multiplication button, it's a multiplication sign. But if I press a second multiplication button, it'll be the factorial. It'll be the factorial given to me on the screen. So second button is working like your shift button. So on the button key, you press the button. Above the button, if you want to access, you press second and then the requisite button. Everybody comfortable till here? These are the basic keys. If you want to store certain value, enter certain value somewhere, your enter key works. If you want to store certain value, your enter key works. Where you want to enter something, where you want to impress on something, you want to store some value inside something, your enter key will work. There are places wherein the enter key would not be required. We'll be looking into that as well. Everybody comfortable till here? In the next one, if you see, the basic functions, your digits are here. Your plus, minus, multiplication, division, equals to is here. One function would be this plus minus sign, you understand. If I write 5 minus, that is 5 minus 3 you would be doing. But if I want to make 5 as a negative number, the plus minus button would be, the plus minus button would make the value negative or change the sign. So that is what this plus minus button would be doing. Everybody comfortable? These are easy buttons. You already know all these things. All right.